We have, over a very long period, been going on trade missions abroad. We have been receiving foreigners coming to invest in our country.
Okay.
We've always talked of foreign direct investments. And we have always seen, when we do evaluation, that there are really things that we can make the best use of in our country. We are not even making the best use of what we already have in the country.
All right.
So we realize that the best is to begin to have collaboration among states that have things that they could share. And therefore, we arranged the two governors, Governor of Kano and that of Lagos, agreed with the suggestion that we should come together for a number of reasons. The two states have certain great similarities. We are the two most populous states in the country. We have the most hospitable people. We are the most cosmopolitan states. We have so many endowments, but varied in varied forms. Lagos is on the coastline, and we are in the hinterland. We have access to a large population of the neighboring hinterland countries. We have in ourselves also the market that is accessed by most part of the rest of the northern Nigeria, and even part of the southern states do access because of the size, the humongous size of northern region. We are able to provide the market is there. And Kano receives an average of about 5 million visitors on almost a daily basis,
Wow.
similar to Lagos in some respect.
All right.
So these similarities, over the years, we realized that when other people keep coming from Asia, from America, from Europe,
All right.
to come in and explore opportunities there, and we see that we have our brothers within the same countries, that we could share things and make the businesses a lot more competitive, especially in the light of the exchange rate that keeps varying at all times. And there is also cost of moving capital from one end to the other, especially on the war against drugs and drugs money and terrorism and all that. So within the same country, the information are very much available. And if we are able to collaborate among ourselves, explore comparative advantages that exist in certain focus areas to ensure that, as you have already enumerated them in your opening,
All right.
we will be able to have some relationship with Lagos that will enable the two states improve the socioeconomic well-being of their people in a very easy way and on a faster track with less challenges and difficulties, no bottlenecks, because in the same country, operating under the same laws and all the rules. So we have recognized that there are things that Lagos will benefit when we meet. It's going to be a meeting of all stakeholders,
All right.
from leaders in government to professionals, stakeholders in virtually all respects on both sides, and we'll compare notes, share knowledge, and come to agree that XYZ could be done better by this, and we could invest in this place, transfer certain capacity from this side. That kind of partnership and relationship that we can now also say, what are the things that Kano people could do a lot better?
Yeah.
And what are the things that Lagosians do today that they really suffer and they could do better? What are the things that the two states need to do so that they could, by within themselves, be able to reduce the difficulties in business, improve the ease of doing business, and make it easier for the people to reap the benefits of their labor with
All right.
greater ease?
Now, how would you describe the investment climate and policy thrust of Kano State?
Excellent. Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje came in with a commitment to grow trade and industry. When he appointed me, actually, his briefs to me were that I should, on a fast track, ensure, because we keep discussing the issue of exploiting opportunities in the global market and also the opportunities within the country. He said, go on, do it, whatever is required, I will do it. And he showed the commitment by making sure that whoever we bring that requires any certain facilitation, which even includes the governor himself leading a delegation to some place outside the country or to Abuja or to here in Lagos, the governor has shown that commitment. We've gone with him and we've been able to achieve humongous results.
All right. Now, this summit will give an opportunity to share emerging investment ideas. What type of investors is Kano actually looking out for?
We are looking at investors, not necessarily investors, we are looking at partners. In some respects, we are going to expect somebody who has certain capacity, technical expert capacity, to come in and will just key into what we have already established on the ground. And in some place, we will expect some people to come in. And let me just mention a few. In the Tigar area, we have got provision of vast land for condominiums and luxury homes.
All right.
Along a coast area, beach facilities, tourism attraction. You know, it was a facility initially developed by the first military administrative Kano state, okay. Late police commissioner Abdu Bago.
All right.
And that is being set aside. Our zoo is going to be grown to a proper safari as people go to South Africa and other parts of the world to enjoy facilities that we could develop better ones in with what we have been endowed with. Mm-hmm. We have agricultural vast lands that are there also. We have solid minerals, and we have need for larger hotels, modern, seven-star, if you like, that today, begging, there is a resident market waiting for it. We have other collaborations in the cost in education. We need so much. Already, we have got some Asians and some Arabians and others coming in to establish universities.
All right.
So we're looking at all this holistic collaboration, Kano State Government and Lagos State Government, and then investors in Kano, investors in Lagos, coming in to partner in a way, because sometimes when you come into my home to invest and you see that I've already put something on the ground, you become a lot more comfortable. And that's the kind of situation. We are not looking at one hand moving into any direction alone. We are looking at a continuing handshake in all respects. We believe also matters of internally generated revenue and governance issues. There are issues that we can compare. And if I can mention this, there were efforts by development partners like the USAID to do the Lakaji, the Lagos Kano Dibia corridor, to facilitate movement of goods from Lagos to Kano and to Niger Republic, and warehouse. These are all issues we are going to sit and then come up with a template that will make it possible for partnership among states. So rather than wait for somebody from far away to come into your country, you could do with that, because we definitely need investors from Asia. We need investors from the Americas. We need investors from all parts of Europe and the Arab world. We need them to come in, because we are also investing in their also in their own economies. We need them to come in and invest so that we grow the economy. The fundamental issue is creation of employment for youth and women. And we believe it is only when you have created employment that you can have a community that has got what they could have on the table in the morning, in the afternoon, and at night. And you can have sane families that are comfortable, not create a situation of unemployed teeming population that will at some time constitute real nuisance. So these are the issues. We are not expecting direct, just an investment, no, a collaborative partnership, in a way that we share the comparative and, if you like, competitive advantages that are in us to make life better for our people.
Right, very good. Now, it's been said that this summit is one of the first of its kind in sub-Saharan Africa in that regard. Now, you might want to argue that, why the choice of Lagos? You could have chosen any other state. So why Lagos?
That's why I mentioned why Lagos. I believe Kano and Lagos, as I mentioned earlier, have got a lot of similarities. There are no two states, and I can make bold to say this, let anybody fault me, no states are as cosmopolitan as Kano and Lagos this country and in Africa, where you can come from anywhere, and as you drop your bag, you are welcome, you are home. Nobody is going to fight you or make life difficult for you. Kano has had this advantage because it was the first gateway into Africa. We have the very first international airport, the first airport into Africa is in Kano. And we have large settlements of all natives and tribes and races in Kano. In fact, some when you see the Arabs and some Europeans in Kano, you just see them by color of skin, then you can... Otherwise, we have intermarried. Some of them have even somehow gone to third, fourth generation.
Wow.
So why we are coming to Lagos? Lagos had at one time been the eighth largest economy in Africa. And then I think it has gone to the fifth.
All right.
But we can pride ourselves. We have donated some of our great sons to Lagos.
Okay.
Aliko Dangote. Kano native, Abdul Samad Issa Rabiu. Kano native, do I go on?
No.
General T.Y. Danjuma.
All right.
Kano native, don't ask me why I say T.Y. Danjuma.
All right.
Because he's more a Kano man than anywhere else, than a Taraba man.
All right.
We have donated, so we have got so many similarities, and particularly people that are aggressive, that are industrious, that are very friendly, very hospitable. These are reasons why we have seen Lagos is on the coastline. We are in the hinterland. I gave this analysis.
Yes, you did.
So when I mentioned the Lakaji that was initiated by the USAID, it was by a development partner. It came in with its own terms and conditions and therefore yielded not much benefit, because whatever is brought in, we have realized that some of them really bring in quite a number of support projects. But because we are not part of the crafting of the policy, it's attested by this consultant and that, and most often a small sample that is oftentimes, you know, faulty, they don't get to deliver the results. Right. If Kano and Lagos now come into real partnership and we say we are going to create a seamless flow of cargo to and fro Lagos and Kano,
all right,
and make certain kind of relationships in a symbiotic way, that we will have, as we have mentioned also, a particular creating an ecosystem that will provide solution providers and invite us, investors. In that kind of form, you are going to have virtually everything under the same roof, and people will be able to make the best of their investment at all times.
Like a one-stop shop, as it were.
Indeed.
All right. Now, you've had summits before, you know, in Nigeria, and people would just say, okay, fine, maybe this is another talk shop. So how committed are both parties, Lagos, Kano, to actually implementing the policies arrived at this summit, individually or on a bilateral plane?
In the first instance, my principal, Dr. Abdullahi Umar Ganduje, the executive governor of Kano State, has shown commitment to all his words since I've started working with him. And I know in their steps, they are action and action and action governors. And when they decided to do this on their own, without anybody imposing it, you know that they are really voluntarily coming into a partnership that they mean to do business. And the person that are coming on, the stakeholders, the samples we have brought together,
all right,
they are actually individuals that are very serious and committed persons.
Okay.
So I believe we have everything going for us in respect of this. It's not going to be a talk show. It's going to be a project that is going to set the pace, change it is said, a game changer. It's going to change the trend of things among states. After we have finished with the settings in Lagos and taken off, get airborne and moving, I trust quite a number of states will say that is the place to go.
Very.
We intend to go on others, but this at the first level, we believe Lagos is the best ride for us to go with.